Hello guys, it's Pete from Bleed Eat Gaming here, bringing you part 29, I believe. We started fighting the Nameless King last episode. This episode, obviously, we're going to try and get him done before the DLC, which I believe is out on the 25th. I'm looking forward to the DLC, see what Dark Souls DLC is all about, see whether it's enough, warrants enough content for what it is, but from what I've seen of the games, I don't think there's any issue with that. So yeah. Oh, by the way, yeah, I've got the older skull face now and try and intimidate the Nameless King. Hopefully he'll be a little bit terrified and stop kicking my ass like he did last time. So this bird's bad enough. Oh. See, the one thing I do like about this fight is that it's probably quite safe to say it's pretty much an all-round fight. Like, you have to be used to camera angle. Or camera angle is something that I am never good at. So you've got to get good with the camera angle. You've got to be able to dodge at any given moment. You've also got to make sure you place yourself in the right position to hit the, hit the boss. And obviously, headbutting his spear, not a great tactic, I'll be honest with you. Get some good damage in there. Oh, we would have. I decided to actually hit his face. Run away, run away, run away, run away. Okay. That's the attack that hurts the most. You get caught in that, like, most of the time, I believe it one-shots you. Which is obviously not ideal. There we go. Fuck you. Chop your bird up. Oh fuck. See, like, the hardest bit about this fight bit in the beginning is your distancing. It's quite hard to read where you're at. Run, 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 run. Quick healing. The bird, this bit, the King of the Storm, it's quite nice, this bit. Like, there are a lot harder bits in different boss fights, not even just this one, than the bird. As soon as you position yourself right and you're prepared to dodge the where he flies up in the air and he breathes fire, because if that hits you, like, you are fucked. This is quite nice when he does that. Just run to the side and get some good damage in if you hit him in the head instead of doing what I was doing there. Almost that killed him. Looks like it. Right, now for the fun bit. They're doing a bit of rogue works and stuff outside. Hopefully it doesn't pick up on the audio too much, but if it does, I apologise. Don't worry, it is like a lawnmower and like a jackhammer. It isn't like the missus left the vibrator on or anything like that, okay? So just keep that out of your mind. I have to admit, as boss fights go, I reckon this is the best boss fight in the game. One, the boss actually looks shit hot. Like, the soul boss, the final boss, I liked the way he looked. The fight wasn't what I was expecting, but, like, he just looks mint. He looks like the kind of bloke that, like, you'd see from a distance, you'd be like, ah, he looks like a bit of a pansy. And then you get a bit closer and you're actually, nah, I'm fucking alright. I don't want to be anywhere near that bloke. I can't see. Alright. Alright. Roll. Ow. I'm sorry. We're supposed to be friends. Okay, that one's quite nice. Just roll under him. What I did last time, I found I was kind of rushing. So this is literally going to be sit there, get an attack in. Wow. See there, got greedy, got punished for it. That was a mistimed roll. Roll away, get drinking. Nice. I think if you can get your... Oh, okay, there we go, I'm dead. That's what happens when you mistime the rolls. That's the one thing I've noticed with him. This is very much a boss fight where if your skills aren't honed, like, if they're not right, if you don't time your rolls right, he punishes you. If you don't notice the bird flying up to breathe fire, he punishes you. It's very much a... I like to call it the rinse and repeat for the perfect run, which I'm assuming quite a few Dark Souls. There's a guy who, he might be down in the comments section, I don't know, his name's Zeri. X-E-R-I-E-H, I believe. He'll know exactly what I'm on about, because if you watch his stuff, like, the guy's godlike. Just flawless running, God knows whatever. You also have Scrublord, he's got a few flawless runs on his, that's what I was going to do. I found a ring, the life ring. Raises XP. I have got boost critical attacks, but I'm happy. Oh, that probably would be an alright one. Slightly boost dexterity. Let's put the life ring on, and I think we're going to put that stone plate one on. Can I still roll? Yes. Okay, that's the main thing. I think what we'll also do is that I might actually add the lacerating effect. As you can see, I'm actually getting used to some of the old mechanics on the old Dark Souls. I've started looking into obviously using the lacerating effects, the lightning effects to apply it to your weapon. And I don't know, I'm starting to feel more at home playing the game. Which, to be fair, I never felt out of place playing it. I've actually always been quite comfortable. Obviously, there's been bits that have been fucking stupidly hard. I don't know, I missed an opportunity then. But it gives me time to get a drink, so... Yeah, this very much pick your time, make sure you're in the right position at the right time. I haven't been hit by one of those lightning spears yet, but I'm fairly certain it's probably not going to be very nice. Chop his bird up a bit. Ow. Okay, I keep thinking I can dodge that by going wherever I go, but clearly that is not the case. Alright, that was a good dodge. His birds. I've noticed as well, if you stay under underneath him, that fire attack that I keep talking about, he uses that a lot more. If you just stay like from nose length apart from his bird, then he stands to do a lot more physical attacks, which obviously you have a better chance of dodging and doing damage. You also have a better chance of not being burnt to a fucking crisp, which I mean, that's all anyone can really ask for, isn't it? Having a day in the office and not being burnt to fucking death. So, right. We're going to add lacerating effect. And I got greedy. I deserved that. Drink. Right. Roll. 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 Chop. Chop. Sorry, I might call out my running choppy attacks, but it's just so I can concentrate on it. See, I think for this one, it... That's cool. Ooh, wrong. If you take your time with it and you pick your times to roll, oh bollocks, you make sure you keep your stamina up then obviously you're in a better position. Oh, that'd do. Whoa, there are new moves. What are you doing? Ow. Quick drink. Take no chances with that. Alright, it's getting close again. Okay, this is going better. This feels smoother. Until I get greedy. That's the thing that I'm really enjoying about Dark Souls at the moment. Whoa, sorry. Oh, fuck. I need to get drinking. Roll! Fuck. Drink. Nice. Okay, that went better. Roll. Chop. Okay. So this is very much... Pete. Come on now. Nice. Okay. Chop him. Oh, fucking come on. What? Say something. Fucking say something. I don't know how to... How do we want to celebrate this? Ooh. Cutscene? Ooh, what does this mean? Oh, fuck. What's going on? I love those gauntlets. They look shit hot. It's like Lord of Sauron shit. Look at them. Boom. Fucking say something, mate. Is that a new bonfire? Right. Well, what I will say, guys, is that that was my fifth, sixth attempt. It might be a few more, it might be a few... No, it won't be a few less. Yeah, it's a new bonfire. So what the fuck is this place? Oh, that bit's opened up. Ah. But yes, what I did do is obviously I got that life ring. I found that Thunderstone plate, which I'm very happy about, because no doubt I would have taken huge damage otherwise. I did do some of my stats. I upgraded a few of my stats. I didn't actually do... the boss fight, like getting used to his style or anything like that. All I've done is go around, farm souls and collect, and I've leveled up a little bit. I haven't leveled up majorly. I'd probably say I've put in probably an extra 6 levels, which can make a big difference. I understand that. But I keep forgetting to turn my fucking notifications off, and it's doing my head in. No, that's not a thing you want. Well, I'm happy that that's that I did that. Was the soul there? Ooh. Oh, that looks nice as fuck. Right, we're sticking this on. It's probably heavy as shit, and I'm going to Fat Man roll. Is it Dragon Slayer armor? Yeah, it'd be Dragon Slayer armor. Alright, let's see how we look. Oh, we look shit hot. Oh, we look fucking mint. Let's have a look what the face looks like a bit.
Hey!
That looks nice. If I go up here, I might be able to look at the legs a bit better. It's like tribal on the legs. Yeah, fat man roll. Oh, is there anything down here? Oh, no.
Maybe?
I don't know. That's the other thing, I've learned to just cut everything. I have to take the armor off, unfortunately. I like that new mask, though. One more coat. Ninja gauntlets. Actually, no. Let's have... No, not have all gauntlets. Bloody hell. These are the old Sauron gauntlets. And I'm going to stick a skirt on. For effect. Boom. I did it again. I got so trapped. But yes, that's the... probably 6th or 10th I'm going to go with. I reckon it's my 6th. So I'm happy with that. Especially as one that I believe is deemed as the hardest boss part of this game. Which I can see why. Like, the dragon bit, if you don't know what you're doing, will fuck you over. Same with the Nameless King. He's an absolute monster. So if you're not, like... getting your shit together, yo, just put me back in this bit, is it? Right, well, I'm a little bit confused what to do now. I mean, I've done it. I really did not expect to kill him that quick. Whoa, I forgot about you. Oh, okay. Now you're gonna get it, Bobby. Oh, you in trouble, son. Yeah, I let you hit me. Yeah, I let you hit me again. That's what we'll say anyway. Poke. Say something. Yay. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to go to the tower, and you have to use red cracked orbs, don't you, for, go to the tower. Bloody hell, we're on Destiny flashbacks. What's going on there? Yeah, I'm going to go to the shrine. There we go, nailed it. And then we're, I don't know, I might do a bit of PvP. I think I might do one more episode of this Dark Souls series. I might just do a solely PvP next year, because I'm done with boss fights and everything like that now. I've covered what I wanted to cover. Obviously, I'll be doing the DLC when that comes out, which is 25th. I developed a lisp all of a sudden. How strange. But no, I'll be doing let's see, strength does nothing. Does nothing. I'm quite happy doing health, actually. I think it'd be good to get that up a little bit more. We got soul, didn't we? So let's go see what Corpsey McCorpse will do for me. So yeah, I've covered, like I said, covered what I wanted to cover. Done what I wanted to do. Lightning Storm. Is there a weapon he does? Storm curved sword. Oh, you got Dragon Slayer sword spear, which I'm assuming probably kicks ass. I don't normally use spears. How heavy is it? Oh, I can't use that anyway. My faith. I need to level up my faith 8 times. So I think I'm probably just gonna break his soul down. It's what I've done with quite a few of the bosses, purely because, like, I have no need for it. I'd rather level my character so he hits hard. Weapons, probably making a huge fucking mistake, but it's done now, isn't it? So tough shit. Who does the? Let's think. Sell. That's what I need, isn't it? Consume to invade another world. I think we should do that. That's what I reckon. Let's do a bit of PvP. I'll round this off fairly quickly, I think. Oh, how can I not use that? How do I use it? Help. Excavation. Okay, it just says consume to do another world. Can I not use it because I'm embered, maybe? Is that what it is? I don't really want to kill myself, to be perfectly honest. There's no other way to be unembered. So... How strange. I'm in a position where I've pretty much got to kill myself. I did do a few leveling of weapons. I'll show you some of them if you like. That's probably the wrong place to show you them. So I'll show you here. I've got the longsword, obviously plus 10. Ithril, plus 5. I've got the black knight sword, plus 5. Which I'm going to have to see if I can use in a minute, because obviously my damage on there is what, 421, whereas that is 549. So big difference in damage there, but it's just whether the speed's there. The reason why I've stuck with the longsword so much is because of the speed of it. You can get a good couple of attacks in, which you can use to stun enemies. I really don't understand why I can't. Or maybe it's because of the place I'm in. So let's go. Anyway, let's go Undead Settlement. Yeah, let's go Undead Settlement. There was a bit of audio between me and one of the characters. He said there's something down the alleyway of Undead Settlement that I need to go to. Or something like that. So something worth checking out. So what I'll do is see if I can use Cracked Orb. If I can't, then we might try and discover, see what he was on about there. I might end this as quite an early video, because all I wanted from this one was to get boss killed. I didn't expect to do it like that, but I think the advantage is that I'm recording during, yeah, it was because I was at the shrine. Yes, I want to invade another world. That's right, people. I'm making my way out into the PvP world. Oh, did I have to stay still or something? Oh, I cancelled it. What? Fucking absolute muggins. Sorry. Invade another world. Let's just wait here again. Can you guys not attack me, please? I'm waiting to go do some PvP. Well, that's not nice. I mean, that wasn't very nice at all. Now you have to die because they angered me, so I had to kill you. Yeah, searching for another world. Let me invade. Wow, that really is a nice view, isn't it? I mean, I have to really step back, because I'm still not even sure how I killed Matey Boy so quickly, but... I mean, what a game. It's a game that I've spread out for a while, because of recording purposes, plus being busy at work, doing a lot of other stuff. I think what we're going to do is that I'm going to go to a place probably a bit further on in the game, and then we'll do it there. Where's the bit that I saw a video where everyone goes for PvP or something? I don't know where it is. It is... somewhere. I can't remember where. It's definitely not this far along. Where is it? I'm trying to think. It's the one where you got loads of giants at the bottom, you got deacons at the top. I think it's just after the Pontiff boss fight. I think. I watched a video. Because obviously I've done what I've wanted to do now, Dark Souls wise. I can watch like PvP videos now. I can find out more about stuff, and that's really good for me. And I don't know. It's for me. It's a bit annoying with the boss being dead that quick. I was expecting to churn out a bit more before the DLC, but at least this way it gives me time to go and have a look at something else and upload whatever I want to upload, to be fair. But I'm not sure which game at the moment. Yeah, it's this bit. I think you go through these doors, and this is where I think this is where everyone does the PvP. I think. What does purple mean? I don't know what purple is. Well, I know what purple is. I suppose that's the wrong way to go about it. I know what purple is, but is it boss? Well, I'm gonna summon him anyway. Oh. Disappeared. So I'm assuming maybe it's found me someone to fight? No? Yeah? Maybe? Anybody? I'm not sure. I hope I'm doing the PvP thing right. Is it literally just crack the red eye, wait for people, see what happens? Yes. And then summon whoever that is. Is it summoning them? That's been blocked off, so I'm assuming it has. Praise the danger though. I don't know what's going on. Anybody? Yeah! Okay, I'm assuming I'd go up there to spawn her in then or something. Just make sure she doesn't spawn behind me. Whoa, there we go. Do I have bow on? Ow. Okay, that thing hurts. Okay, this is interesting for me. I'm not used to this. Okay, we did a bit of hitting there. Right, we're doing okay damage. Fair enough, that was a good shot. Okay, it's close at the moment. We want to get close. No! I fucking got fucked then. Good fight. That was me clapping, by the way. Don't go anywhere sinister with that. I'm a little bit annoyed at myself. I'm assuming that was an actual player. I'm assuming. Either that or they've got like shit hot AI, like better than I would have ever expected. I think we'll have one more PvP and then I'll end the video here. I'm happy with how it's turned out. I'm happy with the fact that I got it done. As well as like one of the hardest ones in the game, if not the hardest. And 5 or 6 tries I think is very fucking respectable. No. Right, we're going to end that. That's for one. Boom. Can you pick your souls up? You can. Excellent. But I believe they get quite a few souls, don't they, from killing you? Do they get your souls, but you can still pick your souls up? Something like that? Right, who's this fella? Right, let's have it, mate. Me and you. Me and you, Dark Souled. Dark Souled. Jesus. I want you guys to comment how long it took you to kill Nameless King. Also wouldn't mind if you commented saying what you might want to see next with me recording wise. I think I'll do one like specific PvP video just to like really embrace it and see what it's like. Whoa, there he is. Are we gonna bow to each other? Yes, we are. Nice to meet you, sir. Alright, let's have it. Okay, this one's a bit more pokey. Oh, okay, he's ready to parry, is he? I don't really want to get parried. Whoa! Alright! No! Fuck's sake. Yes, well done. Fuck, I'm shit. See, for me, it's quite difficult because I think the safety you have with PvE is that it's this is how that enemy moves. This is how that enemy fights. PvP, people can do whatever. And I don't like that. I think the next episode should be a good one. I'm going to stop it there because I can't. I'm in a good place at the moment. I don't want to piss myself off by fucking getting my ass kicked on PvP. So I'm going to end that one here. And I'll do one more part before the DLC is out. And that will be just literally just PvP. What I will like is if you, yeah, like I said a moment ago, write what you want to see next. Write what you guys like enjoyed about the series, if you enjoyed any of it. If you're new, tell me what you liked about this episode. But I think the main thing, what I would like, is not just criticize the series. I would like people to write and say what you would want better from my videos. Because I want, if I obviously enjoy making videos, I enjoy sharing my gameplay with other people. And I enjoy the people you meet through doing that. So, for example, JM, Scrub Lord, that Zeri guy that I mentioned earlier. Those guys are people that, literally just through me playing a game, they could be the other side of the world, or whatever. And just by, this is the beauty of YouTube, why one of the main reasons I like it, is that all because we've... Even if I hadn't have uploaded and I just commented on there, if they hadn't uploaded and they just commented on mine, we all like this game. And purely because of that, and nothing else, start having conversations. You can start discussing what you like in more detail. You can make friends out of it. You can do whatever. And that's, for me, what YouTube I like. That you can just link up with anyone at any time. And it could be about this most stupid thing. It could be about the most serious thing. But it's a platform for all. And that's what I like. So what I wouldn't mind is that what you would want to see better out of the videos that I make. So one, I can improve. And, well, mainly just so I can improve, to be honest. I'll be honest with you. Right, so I will end it here, guys. I will say, like, especially, I'm going to shout out Scrublord and JM especially. Those two guys, like, we're on episode 29, and I know, like, for a fact, they've watched every episode. And for that, I can only say thank you guys, for your support through it. Anyone else watching, those two, go check out channels. Do whatever you want with them. Go sub to them, because they're great people and they're worth having around, or even just subbing and watching their content. So, big thank you to you guys. Everyone else who's just tuned in, everyone else who's just watched a bit here and there, massive thank you to you. That's all I can say. You have, for me, I've really enjoyed making this series, and I hope everyone else has too. So I will see you in part 30, where, by the looks of it, I'm going to get my arse absolutely smashed in on PvP. But apart from that, Dark Souls is going to be done for me until the 25th, which is only 15 days, so you can't really argue that. So I will see you in the next one, guys. Once again, big thanks, massive thank you to everyone. And hopefully I can get better at PvP, because if not, there's going to be a lot of swearing in the next one.